My paper is called Tea Time, a Microcosm of Islamophobia in Norway. If you wonder what tea time is, that will be explained shortly. In 2010, the Norwegian Center Against Racism launched the campaign Tea Time. It was initiated after the center realized that as the numbers of Muslims in Norway increased, so did Islamophobia. Thus, they started Tea Time, a project where Muslims in Norway invited non-Muslims home for tea. The campaign was very successful in raising awareness of common ground between the two communities. But this positive outcome is not my primary interest. I want to show how the discourse around the campaign is an example of the problem non-Muslim Norwegians have with Muslim Norwegians. For example, an article released by the center shows that non-Muslim Norwegians think that Muslim Norwegians are more religiously observant than they really are. To alleviate Norwegians' concern over this issue, the article went on to make the argument that this should not be a concern because Norwegian Muslims aren't really that observant. This is notable as it unintentionally highlighted the fundamental problem we have as a country in identifying with and accepting practicing Muslims. Although disappointing, this attitude is unexceptional in a country where the term moderate Muslim is used to describe the ideal Norwegian Muslim, implying that ordinary Muslims are bad. It is of no surprise that the Norwegian far-right Progress Party is Islamophobic. Faroe Muslims has in fact served as a major part of their platform. However, the problem is not much better amongst the member of progressive left. Instead of promoting religious freedom and equality of all residents, they're trying to defend Muslim Norwegians by making them fit better into our largely non-religious Christian Norwegianness. Thus, in this presentation, I'll show how the project Tea Time is a microcosm of a larger issue within the progressive left in Norway, where Muslims are tolerated, not appreciated, and pressured to become less religious and become more Norwegian. These attitudes are visible in public debates around the hijab, Muslim schools, building of mosques, and all other issues that emphasize religious Muslims. In this presentation, I'll first briefly outline the 50-year history of Muslim immigration to Norway, and while doing so, highlight some of the policy changes that are important for this presentation. Next, I will talk briefly about how Muslims are debated in Norway before outlining the Tea Time campaign and giving my criticisms of this campaign and showing how it also contributes to the larger discourse. So first, Islam was brought to Norway, as was mentioned, by immigrants, and therefore in any discussion around Muslims in Norway, immigration is usually talked about. Islamophobia in Norway is clearly propelled of a fear of the other, and thus Muslim immigrants are a focal point in any discussion about Islam. The term immigrant is not very specific, and in Norway it's sometimes used to describe everything from people who recently arrived to people who have lived in Norway for up to 4 or 5 generations. What I'm talking about here when I say immigrant is someone who's born outside of Norway to non-Norwegian parents and moved to Norway. Like several countries, Norway had a very open-door immigration policy after World War II, where labor immigrants came. Though we did not have a very large immigration population, and by 1970, only 5% of people living in Norway were from outside Europe. The first Muslim immigrants we had were in the mid to late 60s, Moroccans and Turks that came, and then Pakistanis, a group that quickly proved to become important. Though the first Pakistani registered in Norway only arrived in 1967, and the year after, 9 to 10 Pakistanis arrived on the bus from Karachi. And as has probably become clear, we do not have a very long history of immigration to Norway. Only 1967 was the population of immigrants larger than the population that left Norway, in general, not just amongst Muslims. So, we also therefore introduced immigration restrictions much later than other countries, though we were clearly influenced by our neighboring countries. So when Sweden and Denmark introduced immigration control, Norway were quick to start discussing the same, especially after Denmark practically closed their border in 1697 And as a result, or maybe we saw it as a direct result, we got a lot more Pakistanis to Norway. Right after that, 600 Pakistanis came. And although this is not necessarily a correlation, it was seen as such. And so prior to this point, immigrants were talked about in positive terms, but this rhetoric quickly changed. The increase in numbers of arriving Pakistanis from 110 in 1970 to 990 in 1971 made them visible to the media, and thus public debate flourished. All of this led to a debate about immigration control, and in 1975, new labor immigration was stopped. In the discourse about this immigration reform, the term fremmedarbeiderprobleme, or foreign worker problem, was established, though shortly thereafter discussed as the Pakistanerprobleme, or the Pakistani problem. Grønland, a neighborhood east of downtown Oslo that has long had their population be of lower class laborers, became named Little Pakistan. And so we see how this was present in public debate. Although immigration was not restricted, immigration continued through family reunification from all these countries, especially from Pakistan was what was talked about in the largely. So although the number of Pakistanis to Norway initially decreased, it went back up at an average of about 760 people from 1975 to 2013. Though if you take into account Pakistanis emigrating from Norway, this number is only about 513 a year. So, as I've shown, the first time immigration we had to Norway was through labor immigration from Turkey, Morocco, and Pakistan, and then through family reunification after the borders were practically closed in 1975. So after this, we also have a new type of immigration. Family reunification, of course, continued. But in addition to this, we've had asylum seekers. And the four Muslim majority countries we've had the most immigrants for from are Iran, Iraq, Afghanistan, and Somalia. And the time we have received immigrants have correlated to political events in those countries. And we have, of course, had immigrants from other countries. Chile and Vietnam are two examples. But when we talk about immigration in Norway, especially since the late 90s, immigration has been equated with Muslim. So when we talk about immigrants, we assume we're talking about Muslims. This has changed a little since